Hi, y'all. I'm pretty sure that by now many of you have seen the poem given by that feminist about Gamergate. Her name is Eliza Doolittle of Poetry, I think it was. I can't remember.
If you get to call it misogyny when bad things happen to women in video games, why don't I get to call it misandry when bad things happen to men?
And when she was delivering her poem, I was thinking, God, this is horrible. There was nothing in there that was recognizable as poetry. Meter, rhyme, I mean, none of it. Anyone who knows me knows that I don't particularly like poetry, but I do at least understand the distinction between, like, a syncane and catalectic trochaic tetrameter. I know the basics, in other words. I'm no expert, but I can spot the basics. And then when she was delivering it, I was thinking, I know why she's doing it this shittily. It is her fighting against the system. Which seems to be like a concerted feminist effort, because anyone who's listened to feminists when they get up and start talking and start doing song or poetry or anything, know that these people have Van Gogh's ear for music, meter, and rhyme. Everybody remember this group of feminist singers? Anyway, so it's not so surprising that she did it that way, but it was a particularly shitty poem. Speaking of things that are particularly shitty in poetry, I was just dropping a deuce and I decided to scratch one out real fast that I guess that Eliza or Lisa, whatever her name is, could start with. That goes a little bit like this: Hickory dickory dock, this bitch is talking some schlock. The crowd did clap because of her crap. Hickory dickory dock, jiggery pokery smoke. This bitch is a prosodic joke. Gamers did laugh because of her gaff, jiggery pokery smoke. We can start there, lady. Now, in part of that poem, she was talking about how men are statistically more likely to be killed in war, but we gamer folk haven't been in any wars. I happen to be a member of the VFW, the Veteran of Foreign Wars. I've deployed places. And, you know, the funny thing is that when you're not actively on a mission or training for a mission or doing something with equipment, pretty much your time is either trying to get some sleep, food, or fucking around. There is an awful lot of grab-assing going around in the military. It's one of the things I loved most about it. Listen, rape culture supporters, I didn't mean that by grab-assing. I meant having fun, playing games. Like Hide the Pickle, Sausage Factory, and Rape Fest. You know, nothing untoward. Anyway, all kinds of foolish things. Foolish, some of it not. But if you go look, I was never in the infantry, but if you go look at the day in the life of an infantryman, sorry, I get all worked up when I talk about infantrymen. I've never been in the infantry, but I've had a few infantrymen in me, if you know what I'm saying. All right. They spend an inordinate amount of time in their day room playing video games. They also play a lot of games like that on deployments back at various FOBs or whatnot. FOBits play a lot of this. Talk Roaches play a lot of games, video games included. So it's not like this is something that there's not a large population of people who are gamers who served in the military, and there's a some overlap there for people who serve in the military in a combat zone, or in a war, or in a deployment, or something of that type. You know, stuff that you think about soldiers doing when they're out actually being soldiers. And it's so amazing, not really, to watch this self-entitled bitch stand up and disappear out of existence by sheer fiat. All of those hundreds of thousands of people who have deployed to war zones, who've been in combat zones, who've been in theaters of war, and who have played video games. And she's going to compare all of that, the grab-assing, the happy-go-lucky nature of people who are in the middle of fucking wars. You know, they'll be launching, artillery will be coming in, or artillery will be going out, shots being exchanged, and there's always someone there finding a way to have fun.
What the fuck was that?
Oh, cockfight! Cockfight! He's gonna start chasing the chickens.
Get on the ground! Get on the ground! Get out! Get out!
It's hard to look right at your baby, but here's my number.
I see him dying.
Run, motherfucker! Holy shit!
Let me see it one more time. Alright, go.
She'll compare having to look at pixels on a screen to the life that that is like, and talk about the oppression that afflicts her of pixels on a screen versus exchanging artillery and exchanging rapidly moving small pieces of lead with people who mean to do you harm. Those things are really on a par. And if they're not, well, what I'll do is I will just speak out of existence all those contrary, inconvenient examples. Anyway, those are my thoughts on that. Have a great day.